Get ready to match the stars. Jim Backus. Brett Somers. Nipsey Russell. Patti Deutsch. Richard Dawson. And Betty White. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And now here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rayburn.
Hello there.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, well. Thank you very much. Thank you, Johnny Olson. Hi, John. Good. How's everybody over here?
All right.
Terrific.
When are you going to take the basting out of that suit?
The basting will come out as soon as the tailor makes up his mind there. Listen, I think all of us who are regulars and semi-regulars on this show ought to give a brisk round of applause to these two new beautiful additions, Jim Backus and Patti Deutsch.
Give them a hand.
Yeah.
Right across the mouth.
Jim, what have you been up to?
Well, I just finished a thing called Miracle on 34th Street, which will be shown right before Christmas.
I mean the
remake of the old movie.
A remake of the movie.
Yeah, and I play the head of Macy's.
You do?
Yes, I'm very severe. But it's a very funny thing. Years ago, I got a job in Macy's in the tie department and was fired after 2 days. Never could make the tie, you know what I mean? or the sales slip. So now the manager then says, out of Macy's, never even come back here as a customer. So I'm going back to New York to shoot as the head of Macy's.
I
hope that he is there.
That's Hello there, Patti Deutsch. I know all of your fans out there are happy to see you here, as we are happy to see you here. We've seen you on Laughing and all kinds of things.
Thank you.
What's in the future for you?
I'm going to do something on The Girl with Something Extra.
The Girl with Something Extra?
Yes, I'm going to be the girl without something extra. These things happen.
Well, you've got a lot going for you. Nice to have you with us.
Thank you.
Now let's say hello to our two players here, Emmy Rick and Susie Grabiel here. Hello, ladies. Susie is our current champion. She has won $6,200. She's won 2 games, and she's happy about that, as you can tell by the smile on her face. And we had just met Emmy last time, and let's find out about Emmy Rick now. Tell us a little bit about yourself, Emmy.
I'm a former airline stewardess, and I have 2 little girls, Deanie and Tiffany.
Okay. Good luck to you here, and good luck to you, Susie. We'll begin this game right after we hear these messages. Oh, we have a lot of fun here, and now it's time to get down to business.
Right on.
Ladies, are you ready? Here we go. I push the button. We go to round one. Some of our contestants find some questions harder than others, Emmy. That's why we always ask you to make the decision. You may have your choice of A or B.
B, please.
B. Now, you know that you and Susie will be answering questions, trying to match our celebrities. The one who has done that most often at the end of the second round will be the winner, and we'll have a go at over $5,000 in the super match. Here we go. Everybody plays, and this is it. Frank said, Doctor.
Yeah.
Ever since I started sleeping on a waterbed, I dream I'm a blank. Frank said that.
Frank who?
I don't know. Doctor, ever since I started sleeping on a waterbed, I dream I'm a... And Emmy, you think about that and tell
us
how you're
going to... Some of us panelists find some questions easier to answer than others.
That's true.
Yeah, we do.
Yes.
All right. Everybody ready? Now let's find out how Emmy will fill in this blank. And ever since I started sleeping on a waterbed, I dream I'm a...
Fish.
She says fish, folks. You like that answer? All right. Let's see if you and Emmy are correct in judging how these celebrities filled in that blank. Celebrity number one, Jim Backus.
By George, a fish.
Fish. There it is. Okay. That's one for you. What do you say, Brett?
I'm in love with Mr. Magoo.
Yeah.
I said fish.
You said
fish. But I made it specific. Does whale count?
I don't know. I have to tell you the judges. Is that a man?
Fish.
Fish. All right. There it is. Another man. Nipsey?
Frank was talking to his doctor, right?
Frank said doctor, yes.
Oh, yes. I know about doctors. You know what a prescription is, don't you?
What is a prescription, Nipsey?
It's a note to the druggist saying, I got mine, now here he is, you get yours.
Another match from Nipsey. You're up to 3, Emmy.
Pay attention.
Now, Patti.
Yes?
What have you got there?
Oddly enough, it's another fish.
Another fish. Yes.
Good work, Patty.
Atta girl, Patty.
Oh, I hate it. Fish tastes fishy.
Really?
Watch it.
She did one of those commercials. I happen to know the whale's a mammal, but I will also accept their ruling that it's a fish because they're dumb.
They're laughing.
They're dumb.
What do you say, Betty? Fish.
I, almost end. Being a dog lover, I almost said he dreamed he was a Spitz, but I said he was a fish.
A fish.
Got
wow.
Six.
You know, we haven't had a round like that in ages and ages. A perfect first round, Susie. Let's see how you do with this now. Yeah, let's see now. What do you, Susie, you got to match everybody in one round to stay in the game here. Oh, boy. All right, everybody listen carefully now. Crucial time here. Philip's neighbor called and said, "You'd better go home. Your wife is in bed with the blank." Philip's neighbor. He called and said, "You better go home. Your wife is in bed with the blank." Madam, you live in this neighborhood? Oh, I see.
I don't have to do this for a living. You know that.
All right.
I mean, I
okay.
Can go out and sell cars.
Now, let's see what Susie comes up with. Philip's neighbor called and said, "You'd better go home. Your wife is in bed with the blank." Now, you've got to match everyone all the way across. Two. Oh, you'll have two rounds to do it in. All right, okay.
Oh.
How do you do this one?
Milkman. First thing.
So that's the kind of group you are, right? She said milkman, and they're applauding the milkman. All right, Jim, what did you say?
Well, I'm appalled at Susie, really. No, a clean living gym with an image to uphold. I said a virus, which
a
is
virus.
Really a cold handled by the William Morris office.
Bed with a virus. Okay, Brett, what do you say?
I just fell out of love.
Oh, all right.
Virus. Honestly, Jim, milkman.
Milkman. Okay, Nipsey.
Don't judge me by the company I keep. She was ill, so she was in bed with the doctor.
You rascal. Now, did you get the hang of it, Patty?
No, I was still involved with the waterbed, so I said that she was in bed with the fishmonger.
Okay, you know what a fishmonger is, don't you, Richard?
I certainly do. I knew a person who had pneumonia, died, and went to heaven. St. Peter said, "How'd you get here?" He said, "Flu." That's the only clean answer you've had so far.
No,
I will not go for these fishmongers things.
Milkman is her answer. She scored once with it. Let's see if Betty White helps her.
No, I said flu, but actually it was Jack Flu. He lived next on the other side. You know,
and
the
he
house?
Was the milkman, no. All right, so
Betty
at the
White
end of this round, 6-1, you'll have another chance to stay in the game, Susie, and we're going to give you that chance right after we give you these messages. Now, Susie has her chance to tie the score and stay in the game by matching five celebrities. And since you've already matched them all, well, we're going to go right to Susie and ask her to make a selection.
B. I'll choose B.
B is what she wants. And since you matched Brett last time, Brett, you will not participate in this. The others will. The barber accidentally cut off Fred's blank.
I always miss the good ones.
Accidentally cut off Fred's blank. All right.
Is that a true thing?
Got a match. All five. All right, Nipsey's now ready.
Are you? Yes, I am.
Okay.
Yep.
Now, Susie, think carefully before you give us your answer. The barber accidentally cut off Fred's...
nose.
Nose.
Ooh. How did he smell?
Nose. You don't like that answer? All right.
The nose have it.
Everybody, the nose have it, right. All right, got to get five noses here or the game is over. Jim, what did you say?
Had to go... Ears.
No, Emmy Rick is our new champion. Congratulations. You just step down, please. Ear, mustache, ear. Okay, congratulations to you. You've got $100. We'll get back to you in a second. We're going to say a word of farewell. You're kind of happy to leave because you're going to get a chance to spend your money now.
Oh, I'm grateful.
How much have you got?
$6,200.
Well, we're very happy for you, Susie. Susie Gambiel. Let's say goodbye to Susie. Congratulations. Thank you. How do you feel?
Nervous.
No, you're not. You look cool as a cucumber.
I am frozen stiff.
Well, loosen up a little bit now. That's it. Okay, you're going to have a go at the super match here in which you can win over $5,000. You know how it goes. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. April blank. The answer that they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you can match it. Second most frequent response, $250, and the third, $100. Now, which three celebrities would you like to get a little help from?
Richard.
April Fool.
April Fool is Richard Dawson's answer. There's one.
Betty.
Betty White.
April Shower.
April Shower.
Brett.
And Brett. Brett, she chose
Pay attention.
Oh, you see, April Fool and April Shower is terrific. Oh, I can't think of a thing.
What rhymes with flowers?
Okay, time is up, so you got your choice of two answers April, there. April Fool or April Shower or Showers. Or you may give us one of your own. Emmy, what would you like to do?
April Showers.
April Showers is the answer she chose, the one Betty White gave. That's the one we're looking for, and first we're going to find out if it is under the $100 response. April Love. That's a well-known song title.
Yes.
Would you like to sing two choruses, Jim?
Then? No, I do better with April.
All right. We are looking for April Showers. May we see the $250 response? April Fool is up there, the one that Richard gave you. Third and last chance, Emmy, for April Showers. Here is the $500 response. April Showers. Okay. Now, Emmy, you've got the $500. That means you're going to play for 10 times that amount at this point, or $5,000. To collect that amount of money, you must match one celebrity. And it's time to choose that one now. Which one will it be?
Richard Dawson.
Richard Dawson.
Well, that's because I did so well with April Fool.
You get ready to write. You face me, Emmy. That's right. And here is the $5,000 question. Richard, please write your answer to this. Chain blank. That's C-H-A-I-N blank. Chain blank. Okay, Richard has finished. Now, Emmy, we call for your answer. How do you fill in the blank? Chain?
Gang.
Chain gang. All right, Richard. For $5,000, we've all got our fingers crossed for you, Emmy. May we see your answer?
Not unless you give me $2 in cash. Okay. You know those letters you get in the mail?
Yes.
What are they called?
Chain letters.
Well, I wrote chain gang.
Chain gang! Are you happy?
Happy, yes.
You got any friends or relatives out there?
My husband, Peg.
Ow! And who else?
My girlfriend, Peg.
There he is right there in the white sweater is her husband who's waving and happy. And what are you going to do with the money, sir? You're going to spend it, all right. Okay, Emmy, you now have a total of $5,600. You're still the champion. You're going to play another game, so let's meet your challenger right now. Here comes Josephine Williams. All right. I guess you ladies know each other, don't you? You're very happy for her, are you, Josephine?
Right.
Want to tell us a little bit about yourself, if you please.
I'm married. I'm a junior high school music teacher.
Gee, that sounds interesting. Is that interesting?
Oh, yes, it's quite interesting.
Okay, good luck to you, Josephine. You know that you and Emmy will be answering questions, trying to match our six celebrities, and here we go with round number one. We ask you, the challenger, to make a selection.
B, please.
B is what she wants, and this is it. Everybody plays. Brand new game, folks.
Oh, good.
Okay.
A little bird perched on Percy's windowsill, so he blanked it.
What?
What was that again?
You don't believe it either. Would you like to read it yourself? Read it out loud if you would.
A little bird perched on Percy's windowsill, so he blanked it.
That's right. That's what I said. I thought I heard it someplace. He blanked it. Okay, everybody's ready. So, Josephine, we come to you. A little bird perched on Percy's windowsill, so he blanked it.
Shot it?
He shot it. All right.
Shot semantics.
It. Sure. Her answer. What did you say, Jim?
What did I say? Oh, yes, 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 by George. I said he killed it.
He killed it. Is that a match? That is a match indeed. Okay. Score one, sir, Josephine. Brett.
At the risk of incurring Betty White's wrath,
right.
I also said shot.
He shot that bird.
Oh, she's going to be up in arms today, dear.
Nipsey.
This is a violent society here.
That is. That's true.
Freddie owned canaries. I used to ask him, how's your bird? He fed it.
He fed it. That's it. That is. All right, here's a sweet, lovable young lady. Looks very gentle, speaks softly.
Yes.
What did you say?
Well, first he fed it, and then he shot it.
Oh, I see. I don't believe we're getting so many dead birds around here. I just can't believe it. Richard.
His lovely face on this lady.
That's right.
Suddenly said he shot it.
He smiled when she said.
Actually, he did. He fed it. He fed it to his cat, who was a huge. But he fed it.
Yes, he fed the bird. Okay.
Never shoot a bird.
That's right. Now, what do you say? I assume from your carryings on that you're not going to say he shot the bird.
You got that right.
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 Hung it.
He.
He fed it poison drain.
Let's see it.
You never hang your bird, you feed it.
He fed the bird.
Yeah, we're the
so,
ones.
We are.
You had three with that, and we'll get to your end of the round, Emmy. But first, we've got to get to this, and you hurry right back. We've started another game. We finished Josephine Williams' half of the round. She scored three times, and now, Emmy, we've got this for you. See how you do in your half of the round.
All right.
Everybody plays. Confucius say...
Ah. Oh, no.
He...
What?
He...
That's a Chinese accent.
Oh, I...
You can tell by his eyes.
Explain I'm doing a Chinese accent.
I just got the cue.
Confucius say, he who eat dog food soon begin to chase blank. He who eat dog food soon begin to chase blank. You don't like it, huh?
But
you.
I know a joke that would tear this dude.
All right, the lower tier is ready, upper tier.
We're the best.
Confucius.
Confucius said
he
that.
He said that.
Ready over there. Now, Emmy will get your response. Confucius say, he who eat dog food soon begin to chase.
Cat.
Cat. Her answer is cat.
Cat?
Cats is what she said.
Cats.
Yeah, just asked.
You remember Saul Cat.
Sam Cats, oh.
Jim, what do you say?
I said, I said cars.
Cars?
Yes.
Yeah, okay, that's a possibility. Brett?
That's what I said.
No match.
That's the worst answer I have ever heard.
No, it's not a bad
answer. It is very good. It's better than the dialect.
What did you say, Brett? Show us a good answer.
Okay.
He begins to chase dogs, female dogs.
Wrong. No, there are no right or wrong answers
here.
You
would turn on me after I've been so good, y'all.
You scared me when you said Confucius, because I know how he talks. I talked to him a few times. But I agree with Emmy.
So you got a match there, Emmy? And now, Patty.
Yes, I wrote my answer in your accent.
Oh.
Chase calls or cars, as we would say.
Isn't that imaginative of Patti Deutsch to say calls? He had chased calls.
Yeah.
All right, come on now. Richard, straighten up.
Yes, I say chase cars.
Cars.
Very old dog.
I like the dog chase a car on the freeway.
But here's
let's see if we score here.
80 miles.
He chases Mrs. Katz and sometimes Mrs. Nussbaum.
Yes, Mrs. Katz. All right, so there's another match. And it's 3-2 at the end of round one, ladies. We'll start round two after we finish a little business here. Okay, ladies, we've got a little bit of time here, but not enough to finish round two. It's 3-2 in favor of the challenger, and I trust you'll be both with us next time to finish this game, right?
Right.
All right, look forward to seeing both of you. Is there something that I can do for any of you?
Yes, correct your speech until after the show.
Listen, you know, I've been having some trouble. You know that I commute.
I do know that.
And,
well, commute and see us sometime.
I've had a big problem with insomnia. Yeah,
I've
was
got a
wondering.
Cure for that.
You've got a cure for insomnia? Tell me.
Get plenty of sleep.
Oh, all right. Thank you very much. And I hope you'll be able to join us next time for Match Game 73. Gene Rayburn here. Thank you very much.
Today's consolation prizes are for Montgomery Ward's Big Ball Catalog, his or her Stratolite luggage, for those who demand style plus lightweight packability from the Montgomery Ward Catalog. And from Chicken of the Sea, specialist in seafood, an electric casserole plus solid white meat tuna, chunk light tuna, solid white tuna in water, and oyster stew. And a surprise, delicious fill and eat Ready Crust. Your dessert will seem like it came from the pastry chef. Ready Crust, a special treat. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.